Hello viewers, welcome back. Our today's subject is oil versus greases. We'll explain to you the difference between lubricating oils and greases. Let's go to the video for more details. When examining the composition of oils and lubricants, we typically find that they consist of approximately 90% of the base oil and 10% of additives. However, the proportions may vary based on the type of lubricants. For instance, compressor oils are composed of about 99% base oils with only a small percentage of additive, while thermal oils are predominantly comprised of base oils. Moving on to engine oils, they often receive substantial advertising compared to other lubricants. However, with greases, the composition shifts, featuring a lower proportion of base oil, roughly around 70%. Additives account for about 10% of the formulation, and distinctive characteristic is the presence of thickener, which occupies approximately 20% of the volume. Numerous other distinctions exist, and let's delve into some of them. The first is leakage, which is quite evident. For example, bearings are filled with grease. The notable characteristic is that grease doesn't flow as freely as oil. Consequently, it tends to remain in position. Grease has many advantages. For example, we have these bearings in the wheels of the vehicle, and the vehicle is moving very fast. If you put in lubricant, it will all obviously spill out. So greases are used, which remains inside the bearing, and they are water resistant as well. So even if the vehicle, the tire goes into the water, the grease does not come out of the bearing. Then the grease application is done in many other industry, like food industry, where medicines are made, etc., etc., in a sense that if the bearings are used of running the mills or running the machines, there's a less possibility of oil being spilled out from the machine and getting itself mixed with a product which is under manufacture, like food or medicines. Very specialized greases are used, which will remain inside the bearing, and the bearing will keep on working, and in the end, production is advantage with greases than lubricants. Let's consider contamination control, which varies significantly for both oil and greases. One notable advantage of grease is its ability to prevent contaminants, whether it's washed down water or other external elements. For instance, consider a situation where the environment is heavily contaminated with steam or dust particles. In such cases, grease proves to be an effective means of preventing these contaminants from entering the application. Conversely, it's unfortunate that when contaminants enter the application and become incorporated to the grease may actually retain and hold into the contaminants within the application. Once contamination occurs, it can pose challenges. It's really difficult to get it out without an actual grease purge, whereas with an oil contamination, control works very differently. If you have contaminants that are introduced into the system, contaminants are suspended in the substance and transported to the filters for removal. Therefore, from a contamination control standpoint, oil and grease function in distinct ways. If you have an application where frequent start-stop intervals and a low reservoir, opting to grease bearing rather than using a lubricant could be a favorable choice in such a scenario. In an engine, one of the crucial roles of oil is to dissipate heat from the engine. Heat distribution is a vital function of a lubricant, and grease lacks this capability. In high temperature condition, grease cannot effectively disperse, theoretically leading to faster oxidation of the base oil. So if you are unable to effectively carry away heat, this could potentially become an issue in certain scenarios. Thank you viewers for watching our video. We hope we could explain to you and you could understand. For any questions or queries, please write to us, and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.